if we could, it's here. I know I talked to you all back in February. I remember coming out during COVID when you all turned pro and covering you all. But this is what you spent, I assume, the last 4 years working towards one of the big achievements, and now it's here. Is it a nervous excitement?
My gosh.
It's honestly, yeah, like the whole thing is overwhelming. For sure, I would say. Absolutely. It can't be. But it is. It's so exciting. It's scary. It's terrifying. It's amazing all at the same time. And there are so many emotions, and we are just trying to feel all of them. And we do live together. So sometimes I'm just like walking through the kitchen and Kristen's like, Taryn, we're leaving in 4 days. It's just, it's crazy.
To set a goal, and the ultimate goal is a medal, but you're almost there. Just to get to this point, to map it out and have it come to fruition, has got to be some type of reward.
Oh my goodness. Yeah, I don't think, I think that is, like you said, we have, from the beginning, that was our goal, but our goal is bringing home a medal. So I think for both of us, we did have to like take a minute and kind of celebrate the fact that we did make it. Cause to us, we were like, no, like
what's next?
Yeah, the job is not done. We want to bring back some sort of hardware back from this. So our coach had to remind us, be like, hey, like you guys, like, it's okay to celebrate. Like you guys did, you made it. Like all of this hard work, you're here, you're about to go, you've done it.
Is that a little bit of maybe you can relax, kind of getting into the mindset, so to say, that don't put so much pressure on yourselves, that there's already enough pressure because of the journey you've had to take to get here, but just appreciate maybe being there and then just do what you do when you step on the court.
Yeah, that's what he said. When our coach stopped us, because it was one of these practices where we were just melting out here in the heat and just trying to get 1% better. And he's like, stop, stop, stop. And we all just sat down and he's like, do you guys realize what you did? Do you realize what you did the last 3 years? And we didn't take the time. So yeah, I do think that we do, like, again, every once in a while, just reminding ourselves there is greatness in achieving this, even though we have more.
I think recently, actually, one of the other beach volleyball players on the men's side, he was like, we've put in this work for the past 18 months to not go and now just enjoy this one tournament. It's just one tournament, but
2 weeks
just go
life.
Enjoy it. So that is, we are just gonna try and go out and obviously do our best, but just try and soak it all up.
You know your opponents. I mean, you know you're good. So you're going in there. You don't wanna be cocky, but you are confident, right? Knowing that we can do this. We belong here, and that being on that medal stand is where we belong.
Yeah, I think you certainly have to be confident. We actually had a Zoom call with the Kerry Walsh of beach volleyball, and coming home with, what, 3, 4, 5, 10 gold medals. She was like, no, you have to walk in there and own how you play and be confident. And yes, there is a fine line between confident and cocky, but going in there and thinking that we can win, I feel like that does give you a bit of an edge.
You are going to be one of the smallest beach volleyball Olympians ever. I know you said Drew Brees was one of your role models. Do you kind of like, you know, showing people don't judge a book by its cover? Like, you know, everybody comes in different shapes and sizes, and I can do what anybody else can do.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely think the height thing has put a little chip on my shoulder of people definitely look across the net and they are like, wait, I think we're definitely going to serve the short one. Or it is just whatever.
They figured it out.
Whenever we're walking around, it's definitely, I never get the question of, oh my goodness, are you an athlete? It's definitely always going to Taryn. So I think forever that'll always just be a nice little chip on the shoulder and add some solid motivation. But to me, it really does mean so much to just go out and inspire others, especially who are 5-6ers and below. I get so many messages from parents or the actual kids themselves just being like, you've inspired me to like keep working for this dream, and that like absolutely makes my day, makes my year. So just hopefully on this Olympic stage, people can tune in and be like, wait, I could do this as well. That would be really cool for me.
So there's a movie, Hoosiers. I don't know if y'all have ever seen it. Okay, well, look. Okay, I'm in my 40s. Y'all are in your early 20s. We're a different generation. Hoosiers was before you all were born, but I'm glad you've seen it. Gene Hackman is fantastic. So there's the scene when they go to the state championship and he walks them into the big arena and they're in awe. And then he measures the rim and says it's just like in Hickory. I mean, that stadium with the Eiffel Tower as a backdrop is mesmerizingly beautiful. Are you going to kind of have to center yourself and say it's just a volleyball court, even though what is around us is completely unique for what we're doing?
So it's crazy that you say that, because in our last 3 years of traveling and playing in various different locations, we do take a time in the, it literally in the middle of the match, and we say we're in Switzerland, we look up and we're like, wow, we're in the middle of the Swiss Alps. So I think that gives us a new perspective of, hey, we don't have to worry so much about the game. We know what we're doing. We have done this over and over again, trust our training, but look at how amazing this is and look at the location that we get to be at.
Oh my goodness, yes. The amount of people, especially on Instagram, just people posting to their story and just being like, this venue is absolutely insane. I mean, I don't know if you can say that it is not the best venue at the Olympic Games, which I think we're just super lucky and super blessed that it is what we get to do, go do. But yeah, that stadium. I mean, every single interview that we've done, I'm saying, have you seen the Eiffel Tower Stadium? If not, you should Google it.